Buddy, so here we are with the office vacs. Things are always changing, especially over here. I seem to come here a lot to screw around with vacs and stuff. And some vacs have been removed from my house. I don't think I've highlighted those recently, if anybody cares. Usually, I've seen this is important to bring to the attention of everybody because I'll get requests to see verses between vacs that used to be at my house, but because I haven't updated anybody to tell them that they are no longer there, come as a disappointment for that person that wanted the verses. Because I'm sure everybody knows, because I've said this a million times for anybody that watches my videos repeatedly, that can't do a versus of vacuums that are in two different locations. It just can't. I'm going to leave it at that. I'm not going to bother boring anybody with that. Anyway, so seeing that I have, I think, 40-some vacuums here, at least that's what I believe my list says, figured it was time again to start or try to organize, since a couple more vacs have been brought in since my last organization. And if putting a shelf against the wall full of vacs wasn't bad enough, they're now hanging from the wall, at least a couple are for now. But that'll freak the secretary out if seeing this, as I said, if seeing the shelf wasn't bad enough. Oops, see vacuums hanging on the wall, you know. Hopefully they stay up there because I'm only using push pins. But they seem to hold pretty good in that veneer wood crap stuff. So, first thing I figured was to get the small shit out of the way, like that little sweeper and the power nozzles, because they were basically taking up the space of a regular vacuum, and all they are is these little 5-pound power nozzles and a sweeper. That's kind of how I approach. I don't even need to be like have a professional organizer to know what they do. Is you clear the small shit out of the way first. Like that little sweeper, if I were to set that on the floor, that would take up almost the space of a regular vacuum. But I could hang it if I wanted, or if I just stand it up straight and put it in a box, that's even better. So those kind of small shit that can really help you organize. Like, I probably said something about this before in another video, and I'm going off on a tangent here, but anyway, so maybe this will help some people that want to organize their vacuums. How I used to, if anybody recalls, almost over a year ago, I used to spend a lot of time in my neighbor's garage working on stuff and vacuums mainly in there. His garage, when I first met him, was packed to the brim. 2.5-car garage packed to the brim. After, I probably want to say, a year or two of knowing him and helping him clean it, and him helping me clean out his own garage, because I had aspirations of working in it and stuff, because he had so much fun stuff to work on and he had space to work on it. So anyway, after, I'm going to put 2 years on it, I got my 2 cars in his garage, plus all his paint and all sorts of other stuff, in a 2.5-car garage that was about at least a quarter full, the one half was full plus a quarter. So it was like I was getting 2 cars in a 1.75-car garage. It's all just due to shelving and organization and hanging shit, you know? That's how you get it done. So, as you see here, I cleared up a lot of space. The vacuums were all piled out here before. And just by putting 3 vacs and a sweeper and 2 power nozzles on the wall, I've cleared up some good floor space here. Well, it's a big mess. And as I said, I went off on a tangent there. It's just an example for everybody that hanging does wonders, and so does shelving, of course, as you see there. In a space that would usually occupy 3 vacuums on the floor, is now holding 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 vacuums. 2 canisters on the bottom, which you can't see, which works pretty good. And then plus the 2 Reginas in there I stuck in there that would also be part of the space occupied by 2 vacuums. So almost 12 vacuums in the space where normally there would be 2. Same with those bags. I made use of the wall by hanging the bags up. Anyway, back to the new stuff. I believe I probably talked about this before. This was that Kenmore, the helpmate that'll be going to Kyle Kirschbaum. I never properly know how to pronounce his name. Whenever he wants to set up a meeting for that. My pro team, which is still debating the funds to get the handle and cord for it. Expensive handle and cord, I should say. What else? My Breathe Easy, I brought that over here, basically because wide path vacs take up too much space in my house, so keep them to a minimum. And it's not really going, it is an elite of some sorts, but it's not really going with my theme of elites that I have in the section that it was in. Same with my power line and my Rowan Light, which were here before, I probably mentioned. They just never saw much use, especially for the power line, which is kind of loud because of the modified brush housing I had to do for the thing. What else? All the other Dirt Devils. I think I mentioned before I brought my green feather light and the light over because, again, they didn't get used much. There's that 10 amp Bravo 2 I've been trying to sell. What else? There was something else I added here, and I can't think of for the life of me what it is. Yep. Well, I guess that's all the new stuff is. If you pay any attention to it, a lot of stuff's been reorganized in here just because that's another thing I've realized. If you turn the vacuums around and organize them in certain patterns, like different sizes of vacs, you can make a lot more space. Like if you look how you put the Kirby's, if you alternate Kirby's, you get yourself a couple inches per each Kirby because you can jam them up against each other. That's that. If you see that sanitary bag there, I did a little dumpster diving at the vac store the other day and found lots of housing parts, which are pretty good. I found he threw out a Hoover power drive, and I got a rather worn but still useful brush roll for one of those. That's a rarity to find in a dumpster, I think. And I also saved the switch rod and stuff in case that ever snaps on mine or something. If you need a bag housing or anything, I kept that too for the tan colored power drive, just like mine, or a hood. I could go grab that. He also scrapped two Singer uprights, like the Elite style ones, basically the same as the Bissell power partner. I currently have all the housing parts for that, which will be going in the dumpster, my dumpster, tomorrow. So if you want something, say something quick. I don't know, bag cover, latch, something like that, whatever. What else did he throw out? Yeah, he threw out that sanitary bag. He threw out a commercial bag for one of those Orange Royal commercial bags. Almost brand new looking bag for Bissell ProLite and Hoover. Oh crap, what's that thing called? I want to say it's a cleaning light. It's like a professional commercial grade vac. I don't know what he was throwing them out for, but they look brand new. Don't even have to wash them. I vacuumed them out good and hoping to sell those. But anyway, my guess is that sanitary bag is what's supposed to be on my flowery bag sanitary there. So whenever I feel like digging that sanitary out, which I don't right now, I'm going to put that bag on there. And also next to it, as you see, the green convertible, it has been requested to do a suction test with that versus my Ultra MVP. I will have to get around to that whenever I bring some stuff to test it with here, because there is nothing to show a test with. Another funny thing that happened, I probably said, and again, this is a thing if you actually pay attention to all the useless shit I say, was when I got this thing, I couldn't figure out why the brush roll was so loud because the bearings are in good condition. It spins freely. Apparently the belt, which is over here, there's two belts here. This is the belt. Apparently this thing, and you see that is one large belt. It was so stretched out, it was just bouncing all over the place, and that's what was making the noise. And then I put, throw that belt over there, I put the spare belt on, and as I figured, after about 20 seconds of it being on the machine, it snapped. Because as you see, it was sitting on the spare belt thing for a long time, so it was rather rotted and crap and just snapped in half. I really, really hate these belts, but they are really easy to change. And I think they are among the cheapest to buy belts. And maybe that's why they just snap so easily. Like that commercial sanitary at the clinic I was working at. Seemed like they were replacing the belt on that thing like twice a week, and they vacuumed every day with it almost. At least when I was there. I mean, maybe that was because picking up little staples and stuff all the time from it being a doctor's office and stuff, but because the thing gets a crack and then snaps, you know. Whereas I've seen belts, or I've seen flat belts, where they're chipped to hell and that thing's still nice and tight and running like it's supposed to. Then out of nowhere, of course, it could snap just from the pressure, but I mean, it does run. These ones, you get a couple cracks in it, it's expected the thing's going to snap or pop off. That's what the sanitary where I was working at, that's how they knew the belt needed to be replaced, as it would pop off. Yep, time for a new belt. And I never knew that either. But then again, I never really use those machines, and they've had that thing for years, so I guess they know their vacuum well. So that's all that there. And I don't think there's anything over here besides nothing's changed here. There's the three Eurekas that still need to go to Stars 1976 along with his Kenmore and the two shot vacs and the broken Dirt Devil. I really want to part that thing out to get the thing out of my way, but it's just the nicest condition Dirt Devil swivel glide I've ever had, and I might actually have a motor that fits in there. Don't know. That's like the least of my problems right now. Got to put the deck back on my riding mower. Wasn't going to do lawn season, but can't seem to get away with it. So get away with not doing it. So I guess I'll be putting the deck back on my mower and getting all that shit ready because I just bought a bigger trailer. So anyway, I know I'm rambling on here if anybody cares or not, if you're even still listening. For all I know, I could just be talking to myself. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the updates. I probably should do an update video on what's at my house, because obviously if vacs from my house have come here, a couple more vacs have most likely come in my house. In fact, I'll just talk about that real quick while I'm on a rambling rant here. Had a nice conversation, by nice, I put that in big bold italics, with my old lady the other day about more vacuums in the house, because she seems to, every time she comes in the basement, and granted, it is her house. I really don't give a shit. I live there too. Have lived there for the last 15 years of my life, along with her. But anyway, every time she comes down there, she's bitching about some vacuum that wasn't where it was before. And I don't touch the vacuums. I mean, maybe a couple by my desk are the ones I use every once in a while because they're the closest. But in the other parts of my basement, if anybody can recall off memory what my collection looks like in my basement over like by our water meter and stuff where all my hoses are, I don't really go over there unless I needed a model number or something, or I really feel like using one of those vacs. But then again, I rarely use vacs down there anyway. They're just there for show right now. Anyway, so she's always bitching about some vac down there wasn't there before, even though nothing's changed. But this time, of course, she did pick out a couple ones that were added. And I said, yeah, they're added. She's like, oh, you added a vacuum? You know how they get, just bitching. And I'm like, well, I said, here's the stats for you. As I just dropped a belt, that's why the camera went down. Anyway, here's the stats for you. There used to be 125 vacuums in your basement, and now there's 119. So it's irrelevant whether this vac is new or not. When I brought this vac in, probably two or three vacs went out. So you should stop your complaining and just go upstairs. And I think that's a very valid point. Give me your comments on that. I mean, she wanted vacuums out of the basement. I said, well, think of it this way. No vacs are going to leave the basement unless I go with them. So I might as well replace them with vacs that I'm more happy with, such as, why would I want a shitty Dirt Devil Vision down there when I can have a nice Royal, my Red Royal down there, you know? So since I'm not going, I wouldn't be getting, if I had never gotten that Royal, that Dirt Devil wouldn't have gone anywhere from my house. Might as well just replace it with something I like. And in the process, I decided, I determined that I actually now adopted a policy that for every new vac I want to bring in, I'm going to take two out. Because that's how my basement, and I've kind of gotten annoyed with my overcrowding of our own basement myself, because I mean, as she often says, for years I snuck vacuums in the basement, and now I've got 120 something in her house, you know. And shame on her for being a dumb idiot that she is for not realizing all these vacuums piling up over 3 years, I think it was. But anyway, where was I going with that? So yeah, I've kind of realized that it's gotten out of compared to the amount of space I have, it's gotten out of control. So anytime I bring a new vac in, most likely at least one or two are going out. And that's how some of these vacs that are at my house ended up here. And I keep forgetting what I wanted to say. But anyway, so I mean, like, with like this Bissell, nothing replaced this vac. I just felt like taking it out because she kept bitching it was in the way. So I figured to get it out of the way. But then she comes down there and starts complaining about vacs that weren't there before. And I'm like, wait, look at it. You want vacs out of the basement. You're lucky you got them out. The only reason you got them out is because I got other machines I like better that replaced them, you know? And then I decided that I wanted more room for those other machines that I got. So I took more machines out. And I really wish I could use that threat of leaving against her. But I don't really have anywhere to go. So I'm stuck there for a minute, but she's going to have to live with the vacuums because I live there. Anyway, I think that this last 5 minutes has like probably been a waste of your time and my talking. But who knows, maybe you find listening to other people's issues and funny stories funny or enjoying. Anyway, that's the last anyway. Hope you enjoyed the update. More updates to come as always.